How are you?
I'm fine, sir. Thank you.
Was the waiting time was more, or you expected this time to happen, or did the bureaucratic delay happen?
Yeah, some kind of a delay actually. I was told the interview time was 3:30, but I think there was some kind of difficulty.
Okay. What is exactly the meaning of Ashik?
Ashik actually is derived from an Arabic word which means admirer or lover.
Okay.
And it has later adopted into different languages, which all means the same meaning.
Acha. Okay, Ashik. So you are admiring the civil service as trying to get into the civil service, is that?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Right. Now you are from Kerala, Alua and all. So during the floods of 18 and 19, where were you?
During that time, actually, I was at Trivandrum, sir.
You are in Trivandrum.
Yes.
So, were you affected, or you are where you are living was affected?
I was at Trivandrum, and Trivandrum was the least affected area in the in Kerala. Actually, my home was affected. My home is near Periyar River, so
okay,
it got flooded actually.
Okay. What would have been the loss?
To myself.
You know, to your house, to your family, and all, in terms of if you quantify.
Okay, if I can quantify in monetary terms, it would be below 10,000 rupees actually.
Because
my ground floor of the house got flooded actually.
That's all. So you're cleaning, nothing damaged and all, shifted it and all. Okay.
We actually got time to shift the things, but there was a lot of cleaning to do after that.
So that would cost only 10,000. Nothing more.
It was below 10,000 actually.
Okay, good,
the problem was I was actually writing my mains examination at that time. So I was not at my home at that time.
But your parents were there, no? Your
parents. Yeah, my parents and my brothers were there.
Okay, so will there be another flood of that magnitude, will it come, or is it likely, or what is your reading?
So that flood was actually called the flood of a century because it was after a long time. But I think there will be there is potential and possibilities for the such kinds of large floods in the near future because of the climate change and variability that we have been seeing in the global climate. Sir.
No, the 18 flood was very specific. It's because of the man-made floods. It's predominantly of the nature was there. But I think we let open all the dams simultaneously without proper information, or even if information, nothing would have done. That was the major mistake done by the KSEB, predominantly our irrigation department.
Yes, sir. That was also there, sir. Dam management was a major issue, sir.
Major. Because they stored it for water, and then water was already filled, and they have to compulsorily this one.
Yes, sir.
Right. Now 18, we said rebuild Kerala and all we have studied. Is it anything has happened in the Alua area after that 18 flood, 19 flood? Now we are in 2020. Is it anything infrastructurally, visibly has happened in that part of Kerala which was badly affected?
Alua was one of the most affected towns in Kerala because of the proximity to Periyar River.
Periyar, yes.
So, as part of the rebuilding activities, many people were provided homes and houses. That kind of infrastructure rebuilding activities have been going on. Now also it is continuing because last year also there was a major flood.
Okay.
So, that is one thing happening. So, can I continue?
Please go ahead.
Okay. Apart from that, there is, on the land use wise, stricter enforcement of the land use rules is now being followed so that any kind of new construction activities is not being taken up in the flatland area or closest to the rivers. So encroachments are being cleared out and new construction activities are not being permitted.
Is it visibly, in the ground it is happening? That's what you are saying.
Yes, sir. In the ground level, it is happening, but it is not entirely changing the picture. Like the wall infrastructure is not changing, but small changes are happening.
Okay. So that means the vulnerability is not going to be reduced.
Vulnerability is going to be reduced, but I think it's in the short term, it is not going to be reduced. We have to take actions in the long term, sir, because already encroachments have happened and there are many go-downs and shops that is already present in near to the river. Okay. So it is not easy to have a short term result, I guess.
Have you seen the district disaster management plan of Ernakulam district?
No, sir.
So you're an aspirant, civil aspirant. That is not a love letter book or something of the district collector or the SP. No, you have to read it. It is a public document. It will be. It should be in the website. Please have a look on that.
Sure, sir. I haven't read a specific document of Ernakulam till now.
You should, because that is what where you are living and all.
Okay, sir. Sure.
Okay. Two. Do you know swimming?
Swimming, yes, sir. I have actually taken a coaching in the district. So
you can survive for some time in the water. Yes, you will not drown.
No.
Okay. Have you insured your house after that flooding?
No,
have
sir.
Have your house have been insured after that flooding?
No, sir.
No. I think it's that. Then what is the lessons we are learning? You can't expect Pinarayi Vijayan to come and insure your house and safeguard your house. You have to individually do your responsibility. Okay.
Yes, sir.
Now, I would ask, I think, do you drive?
Sorry, sir?
You know, two-wheel driving and four-wheel
driving.
Yes, sir.
I drive.
Yes, sir. Very good. Okay. So, do you know CPR?
CPR as in the activity.
No, artificial. Can you, while you're driving, you knock down someone or somebody has fallen and remaining in the road. Okay. Do you know, practically, have you given any artificial respiration to anyone?
Actually, I have read about it. I know the procedure, but I haven't done it personally, sir.
That theory will not work. You will kill the person. You have to have it. If you are a full-fledged citizen, that too in a flooded area, if you don't know CPR, you are not a full citizen. Okay, okay, over to Sudesh.
Right, I'll try to learn it, sir. Sure.
Please, quickly.
Ashik, you are basically an engineer, isn't it? Working
yes,
with
sir.
TCS?
Yes, sir. I used to work in TCS.
Now you're not working?
No, sir. I resigned after 2 years.
How old are you now?
I'm actually my birthday was last week, so I'm 28 now, sir.
28.
Yes.
So you're from Kerala. Yes. Typical of Kerala, like around 3 years back, we had some cyber misguiding of youth. We left around 21 people left Kerala from Malabar region. They joined the Islamic State.
Yes, sir. There was an incident.
What is it that attracts the people to the cyber world for all these illegal activities like terrorism and all those things? And how can we ensure that our population is not badly affected by such propaganda by the militant outfits or terrorists and all? What do we do?
So I think we have to take a multi-pronged approach here. First of all, this happened because of the online radicalization or in the cyber way, as you said. So we have to strictly regulate our cyber ecosystem so that such kind of messages from the radicalization organization should not come. Then we have to involve the community. We have to engage the community leaders so that this incident happened particularly with reference to the Islamic community. So in madrasas and other religious institutions, such kind of sensitization can be given with the help of community leaders so that people don't stray out of the mainstream. Along with the legal enforcement, we also need community engagement.
Community engagement, isn't it? Mm-hmm. So similar act has taken place in your place also. One professor's hands were chopped off.
I'm sorry, sir. Can you repeat the question?
In your place also, one professor's hands were chopped off. You know that case?
In Idiki,
one professor.
Yeah.
Yes. Okay. That was around 10 years or 11 years back. That incident happened because there was a controversy related to the question paper being set by a teacher related to a university exam. And some orthodox sections of the, religiously motivated sections of the society actually attacked him and chopped his hand off. So that was a really tragic and unfortunate incident that happened.
So how is the handling of COVID-19 pandemic by government of Kerala? How is it? COVID-19 pandemic handling by Kerala
sir,
state? How is the response of the government of Kerala?
Sorry, sir. Your sound is getting disturbed, sir.
The handling of COVID-19 yes. pandemic by government of Kerala for over the last almost 3.5 months. How is it?
Yes.
Is it effective or successful? Not successful.
It was found to be effective, sir.
Mm. Can you elaborate on that?
It was found to be effective to the sense in the sense that we were yes, sir, sure, sir. Because it was found to be successful in the sense that we were able to contain the spread to a minimum level. And as of today, there is no big evidences of community spread in the state. But recent developments for the last week, the IMA and other organizations are warning that community spread is silently happening in Kerala. So I think initially the government did well in the containment, but the influx of the expatriates from other countries, especially the hotspot regions in India and abroad, it has complicated the situation a bit.
They are expatriates or Malayalis who are settled abroad, non-resident
Keralites? Yes, sir. They are non-resident Keralites. They went for job in other countries like Gulf region.
They are expatriates. They are not here. When we talk to expatriates, they are other than citizens, right?
No, sir. Kerala citizens, Malayalis only, who are working in the Gulf region and other countries like USA, they are coming back to Kerala right now because of the pandemic.
So we should not use that term. We should call them non-resident Malayalis who are returning home, isn't it?
Okay, sir. Sure.
So should the government ban their entry to contain the COVID-19? Why should we allow them to come when the disease is spreading? Why should we allow them?
So they have a right to come back to their home state, but it should not be done in an unregulated manner. So an outright ban on their income is against human rights and I think humanitarian values. But I think we have to institute a mechanism such that their inflow doesn't result in a huge spike in the corona infections in the state.
But the government of Kerala requested government of India that they should be medically examined before they board the flight, but that requirement was not enforced. So when you are sitting in an aircraft, you don't know who is infected, who is not infected. So many people are contacting in the flight itself. So how do we regulate that?
As you said, there was an instance like that. But the issue was that the countries from where they are boarding did not have the protocol or did not have the capability to do that. So the alternative taken was that every passenger who are coming through flights should wear an PPE kit overall, so that it would at least minimize the chance of spreading within the aircraft. So.
Thank you. Over to Mr. Satya.
Sure, yes, sir. Thank you, sir.
Actually, there is an issue with the video and audio. I'm sorry.
Yeah, it's there.
So whenever difficult, you please come out and tell, sir, not audible, or then I think you shouldn't be suffering.
Okay, the audio is fine, but the video is not.
Okay. So how is it now? Is it okay? Can you hear me?
Actually, I can hear you, but I can't see you.
That's right. I can see you, so I think that serves the purpose.
okay.
Anyway, so I think you're optional sociology, I believe.
Yes, sir.
So then can you tell me why a successful person like Sushant Rajput has to commit suicide? What makes a person like him commit suicide?
I don't know the exact value, but exact reason, but if I can guess, there were certain mental issues that he suffered, because there were reports that he has been undergoing treatment for clinical depression. So that might be a reason. Also, another social reason that I would see in this scenario is the lockdown, the isolation instituted by the lockdown might have affected him, because the WHO itself has warned that the social isolation and the isolation from the loved ones as well as from the larger society has created larger chances of mental depression. So that might be another reason that has triggered the
No. How can that be a trigger? See, it's like if you want to meet someone, you can just go after 10 days and meet anybody. So I don't think lockdown is the reason why it has actually pushed him to the level of committing suicide. So as a sociological student, so what can you, how can you pin down as the reason for a man who's successful committing suicide?
So I mentioned that because I recently read a WHO warning which said that the risk of suicides is increasing.
Leads to depression, I understand that, but see, you cannot explain it like a layman. You have read suicide by MIL.
Okay. Based on sociology. Okay. If I can, if I have to explain based on sociology, MIL Durkheim actually explained it on the basis of entropy. Which says that the integration with related to society affects the suicidal tendencies of a person. So if a person feels that he is not integrated with the society, there is a chance of him committing suicide. So that could be a reason which so that could be a situation which could be accelerated by a lockdown situation, sir.
So was he not integrated with the society? He seemed to be most wanted person in the society all the time. So how can you say he is not actually integrated?
He might have felt alone because of the apparent, it was alleged that because of the high nepotism of the industry, he was being isolated from all the parties and occasions.
We cannot talk about hearsays and rumors, right? Okay, anyway, let me just go to the next question. Since you have electronics as your graduation, have you used Arogya Sedu app? Have you used it?
No, sir.
You have not even downloaded it. So because the government has given an app for the citizens for well-being during COVID situation, and you have not even bothered to know what it is all about.
No, sir, because I didn't download it because I was told that it is mandatory for persons who are going out. And since the lockdown started, actually, I haven't left the...
Right. But as a civil service aspirant, if you know that what is something revolutionary coming from the government, I was just curious enough to know whether you were curious to know what it was all about or not. Anyway, so...
No, sir, I haven't downloaded.
Okay. So this is the next question is with respect to COVID testing. Kerala has been doing a very good job in handling COVID. That's what that is the national news out here. So can you tell me the difference between PCR testing and antibody testing? Tell me the difference between PCR test and antibody test.
Sorry, sir, I still didn't hear the question.
Yeah. Can you tell me the difference between PCR testing and antibody testing?
Okay, sir. The RT-PCR testing, which is known as the golden standard of testing, is actually looking for the genetic materials of the virus that is present in the body, sir. And the antibody testing actually looks for the presence of antibodies that was created in response to this genetic material of the virus in our body, sir.
So which has higher specificity among the two tests?
The RT-PCR is the golden standard, which has got around 70% of reliability, sir, and accuracy.
My question is specificity. Why are you using a new term, reliability? I asked you which has higher specificity, right?
So I think RT-PCR, sir.
So do you know what specificity means?
Not exactly, sir, but if I can take a guess, it refers to the ability of the test to specifically conclude a positive case.
Okay. So my last question is, with respect to police and violence associated with it, on one hand, if there is a huge crime rate in the society, see, we are a society who cherishes extrajudicial killing in terms of, in the case of Hyderabad encounter. At the same time, we seem to condemn the police brutality when it comes to the Thoothukudi incident, right? How do you actually view this dichotomy?
Sir, I think instead of a dichotomy, there is a clear link between these situations because the extrajudicial killings performed by the policemen as well as these custodial killings is outside the bounds of law. So,
my question is, society seems to cherish, if at all it happens to be an extrajudicial encounter, we are not sure whether it is one or not, But if at all it is an extrajudicial encounter, what happened in Hyderabad, society seems to be cherishing it. At the same time, it seems to condemn this extrajudicial killing which happens here. So how do you see society as a sociology student? How do you view this dichotomy in the behavior of the society?
Okay. So basically, the difference between the response of the society is, I think it is because of the pent-up grievances that is in the society against the judicial system in the country. So the society believed that in the extrajudicial killings, those persons who were accused were actually convicts and they deserve the punishment. And in this case, the society believes that these were innocent people who got murdered by the police. So the outlook of the society towards the judicial system that is actually notorious for its delays and issues might be the reason why the society...
That is not the answer. Responded. I'll just get to the answer once the interview concludes.
Okay.
Yes, I'm done with it, Krishnakant. Okay. If you can.
Yes, Mr. Krishnakant. Yeah.
Yes, sir. I would like to ask about how globalization and corona are interrelated in present context.
So corona, as we all know, is a respiratory disease which is spreading. It's a respiratory disease which has got high infection potential. And because of globalization, people are the movement of people across the world is higher than ever. So the chance of spreading of the disease is much higher. And that is the reason why it became a pandemic in the first place.
So do you think that globalization has, in one way or other, has given more big negative impact on the world compared to the positive impacts?
So I don't think it has got more negative impacts rather compared to the positive impacts it has. But I think the globalization, though the globalization facilitated the spread of the pandemic, we cannot blame globalization for all the negative effects. Because one of the reason the pandemic spread in the first place was the lax response in the part of China when it hit the data about the virus or the spreading of the pandemic in the first place. So I don't think we can blame globalization for the spreading of the pandemic, sir.
When there is any pattern with respect to spread of this infectious disease specific to continents and countries?
Yes, sir. The initial spread of the virus was in China. And after that, it was the European countries and Western countries that got affected. And when the peak of the virus started declining in European countries, the Latin American countries and the South Asian countries like India and Pakistan started seeing the peaking of the disease. So there is a pattern in the sense that there are multiple peaks happening in the world at different times.
Okay. So since your dad has worked in commercial tax offices, you might have seen the taxation very closely. Okay.
Yes, sir.
If you see compared to direct taxes and indirect taxes, mm-hmm. how do you see the burden of taxation lies with whom in direct and indirect taxes?
So the basic difference in the direct and indirect taxation is the burden because in direct taxes, the persons who are taxed directly bears the burden. And in indirect taxes, people indirectly pay taxes for the goods and services they are buying from the retailer also. So the burden shifts from the person who is paying the taxes.
What is the contribution of direct and indirect taxes to the overall taxation percentage wise?
To Indian budget, sir.
Yeah.
I don't know the. I mean, I can't recollect the exact percentage.
Okay. And what about ease of doing business? Which country really is faring better, and who releases this index?
So the ease of doing business is an index released by the World Bank.
Parameters. What are the parameters for it?
So there are different parameters. I think there are 9 parameters, which includes the ease of starting a business, like enforcing contracts, getting permits for construction, then getting the credit for the business, and ultimately the insolvency laws, which helps the exit of a business. But I can't remember all the parameters exactly.
Sir. Ranking of India?
Sorry, sir?
Indian ranking? Rank.
Sorry, sir? Rank of ranking. Oh, okay, sorry. Sir, I think it's 75 right now, sir. I'm not exactly sure. It is in the 70s.
How has taxation regime changed in indirect taxes? In what way it has helped, and what are negatives?
The change of indirect taxation in India.
Yes. Post GST.
After GST.
Yes.
Sir, GST was a revolutionary change in the sense, in the arena of indirect taxation, in the sense that it codified and consolidated all that in the most of the indirect taxes that is present in India. And it actually helped, it should have helped the customers in the sense that it reduces double taxation. But the issue was that many people have found loopholes in this new system. So it has got teething troubles, and the government is actually facing a reduction in the estimated amount of taxes, sir.
Okay, what do you mean by these strategy games?
Sir, strategy games are those games which gives the player a level of independence and autonomy so that he can make decisions which directly influences the outcome of the game. For example, the chess is a strategy game, sir, because we involve different strategies. We exhibit different strategies which actually determines the outcome of the game. And I usually play video strategy games, sir, which are real-time strategy games.
Okay. Being a software employee, what is the way forward? What do you think this in the phase of unlock? Should software industry be opened up, or should it continue as work from home? And what are the protocol ahead in the COVID situation?
So I think... the software industry is one of the industries that where the work from home concept can really work easily. So given the COVID situation and the guidelines regarding to physical distancing, it is better if we don't open up software industries and stick to work from home, because software industries, the use of air conditioners is necessary to keep the systems cool. So air conditioned rooms are one of the enclosed spaces are one of the places where the chance of infection is high. So I think we should stick to the home work from home concept at least for now, sir.
So what change has come in terms of contribution to economy? How much loss are we incurring based on this software industry alone, software sector alone?
So I don't know the exact amount, but the contraction is happening. The figures given out by various rating agencies show that the contribution by every sector has reduced except the investment in the digital or internet technology sectors, because that is the only sector that is that has not been affected really by the pandemic.
Okay, I'm done with my questions.
Okay, thank you. Ashik, just before you leave, Kerala is always said as God's own country. Yes. Where is the oldest mosque in Kerala? And it's said that in the first century, there are 7 churches were constructed in India, much before in many other parts of the world. Where are they? Any idea?
So the first oldest mosque, the Cheraman Masjid, is in Kodungallur.
Okay. Why that name? Why that name like that?
So it is called the Cheraman Masjid because it is believed to be constructed by Cheraman Perumal, who converted to Islam in the 7th century, sir.
Okay. About the other churches?
I do not know about the exact places where these churches were constructed, but okay. I think it is related to the arrival of
St. Thomas.
Christ disabled, yes.
St. Thomas in Kodungallur. So what is the biggest, impressive... lessons or messages you take from Hinduism? As a person, possibly you may be practicing Islam.
Yes.
Is it anything you have taken from Hinduism while you are living?
So one of the concepts I am attracted to is the concept of Advaita. Primarily because I studied in Kaladi, which is the birthplace of Shankaracharya.
Okay.
Yes. And Advaita philosophy actually propounds the idea of Aham Brahmasmi. That is, the individual soul is the same with the Brahman and everything else is Maya. So I think it is an idea which helps us to relieve of stress when stressful conditions arise. So because when if we think that these stressful conditions are nothing permanent and this is transient, it is easier for us to move.
Thank you. Thank you, Ashwik. I think we will call you back in a few minutes. Okay. Thank you.
Thank you, sir.
Okay.
Ashwik, just to leave for a few minutes, we'll call you back.
Okay, sir.
Okay.
Thank you, sir.
Oh, I think we are trying to, I think, adhere to that time, but still maybe five minutes, that's it or so. Okay.
Okay.
Yes, Ashwik, you can be, you can leave for a few minutes and then we will call you back.
Leave for, again, okay, you sir. Can rejoin.
Possibly not able to, audibility.
Yes, sir.
Okay.
Sir.
Right, I think overall, what is the our panel view? Good. I think we'll start from Krishna Kamji, I think fresh this side from that.
Sir, I think there are questions we are framing, but time limit we are not able to manage.
Sir. I know. Okay.
So I think, sir, everyone is covering every sector. We can cover specific sectors like that also. If it is done, we can cover in time.
No problem. What I'm telling, time we will try to here and there. We will maybe 5 plus 10 is okay. No more, because the boys should also benefit. We have got little liberal time. Okay.
Yes, I feel, sir, he is very little bit casual in approach, more serious and more methodical answer he should present.
Okay, right. Then what we will do, we will call him and then make an observation, then that's better. It's right taking, then again, that's better. Huh? Yes, then Chandru, you can call him.
Yes, call sir. Ashwik. Yes, sir. Yeah. One moment, sir.
I think without tea time, I think we can pasteurize. Suppose I'm adding my tea. I think hope all have an access to the tea and all. But I think also Sudesh. Yeah.
Sir?
Yeah.
No, sir, this thing is that little illogical type when he gives the answer, and that train of thought is not there.
Okay.
It doesn't go of thoughts sequentially, you know, that what is the issue, how to solve it. That approach is not very serious and all.
Okay. Well,
way he answers become very casual, like, I can't recall.
Okay.
That he uses almost in every question when he answers and all. So basically, either say, I don't know, but sorry, sir, I'm not able to recollect. I can't imagine that you are not able to.
Okay.
So he has to change the language also.
Okay. I think the words are, every word he speaks in that 20 minutes or 25-30 minutes is matters a lot. So, right, we will give that feedback and all. Vitta kadaikiradhu kashtam illa Chandru. Avangala vittitona thirumba getting back is by, because again they have to get in and all that.
Illa sir, avangala thirumba indha password port and ID port ulla varanum sir.
And the connecting. You understand Tamil? No.
No, sir. Little. Telugu and Kannada, sir.
One advantage of online interview is very good, Shankh.
Enthusiasm, that energy, that impresses the board and all. That will certainly improve the panel and all. But in terms of subject matter, your answering, I think you have to be little more, because within the 20-25 minutes, you have to impress your service commission, no, the members. Okay. So okay, that matters a lot. So I think the panelists will just give an observation. Just keep it in mind.
Okay.
Otherwise, it's okay.
Right. Okay.
Yes, Kanji.
Sir, what I feel that the interview process should be engaging. So yes, you should be very keenly involved in giving the answers and making the other person engaged. Mm-hmm. So your appearance and overall get up should be very much, very disciplined. It should appear, and you should give answers very carefully, little bit of thinking and then giving the answer and arranging in a sequence.
Okay.
So that way it will appear more, you know, seriousness on your part. So be very serious and your face is pleasant, smiling. It is there. But at the same time, your seriousness should come out in your answers and thoughts.
Yes, sir.
We feel rest. Everything is good.
Okay, sir. Okay, the main issue was I couldn't see your faces. So it was awkward for me to answer.
Oh, that limitations. But we want to give you a feedback. But we have been observing these inputs. Just take it. When is the interview? When is your interview?
21st, sir.
21st. So there is enough time. Try to gear up,
sir,
and
sure.
all that.
Sure, sir.
Over to Mr. Sankhya Krishna.
All the best.
Yes, sir. Ashik, somehow I got an impression that you were a bit very casual. I think that is because of your smile throughout the interview, along with probably your hairstyle, I believe. Is it the same hairstyle you're going to go to the interview, or you're going to...
No, sir. I was not able to cut my hair because right now I'm in a containment zone. So I will take care of the grooming.
And added to that, what has happened is whenever there are a lot of areas, I have even written it down.
Okay.
So when you were asked a question, are you working? Then you with a smile, you said, sir, I used to work. So that is, instead of saying that, you could have said that I was working earlier, sir, but right now I have resigned. So that is a more formal way of saying, rather than your communication was as if you're talking to a group of friends or you're going to talk to your leader in your office. No, that don't ever make it informal that way.
Okay.
That was one something which I noticed. Then another issue that I noticed was when you were asked a question, the last point can be a very general answer, like we have to have a multi-pronged approach, sir. The first point, you should not use a jargon like, sir, we have to have a multi-pronged approach.
Okay.
So first, you should be more specific. And as time goes on, at the last points, it can be more generalized. So this actually can put a negative impression in the minds of the panelists that maybe he's not knowing it and he's just trying to somehow cover it.
Okay.
So see, the kind of face that you have right now is what I actually expect you to have throughout the interview, not that smiling.
Actually, the thing is, I had got a comment or feedback in the previous interviews that I should smile more. So,
smile is okay. Good.
Okay. So, and again, with respect to the questions, also, I find the answers were a bit. You can still think. You can see what I would say is spend some more time thinking about the answer, and probably then you should start answering it.
Sure.
Even when I asked you about the dichotomy in the perception of the society. So, as a sociological student, you should have said that with respect to criminals, the society does not feel any kind of a connect. But these are middle class citizens, normal common men. So, a society feels a connect with them. So, a violence against them is perceived to be a violence against the society itself. So, hence, the society feels threatened in this case.
Okay.
So, this connection I was actually expecting from you in your answer.
Okay.
So, these are the suggestions from my end. And do definitely understand about the app Arogya Sedu, because you're going
to install it quickly as possible.
Yeah. Over to Sudeshji. Ashik, the one thing I was asking about that handling in Kerala, please go to the website of health department. You can lot of material, you can just write down what we have done and what we are doing now, isn't it?
Okay, sir. Okay.
Then second question I was asking asking about that boys who were left for the Islamic State. So they were indoctrinated from a particular institution. Actually, they were working there because I was handling that case.
Okay.
It's not that we don't take care of them. So we have done a program, Kerala Police. I think that operation was done. So you can just refer to that and find out that. And after that, we didn't have a very serious case and we are monitoring very closely. Isn't it?
Okay.
So that's one. And second, what I mean that is arrival of Islam, who was the person who converted that particular king? So you should know that historical, the first mosque came up in that particular place, isn't it? Then there it traveled to Kannur, it traveled to that particular family Shiri, then all.
Yes, it was Malik ibn Dinar who converted.
Yeah, Malik Dinar, Kasargod and all.
Yes.
And that king, when he went for Hajj, actually he died on the way in Salalah, Oman.
Yes.
So his bazaar is still there.
Okay.
People
okay.
still visit that. So that little bit historical, this thing is there.
Okay.
Otherwise, I think regarding the rebuild Kerala, you can see the document. What sir suggested, the DDM, the district disaster management, that plan.
Okay.
So that you can refer and rebuild Kerala document after the floods. So your area was not most affected. There are different areas which are most affected. Like Chalakudi was also another area. So what was the response that time? Why it was caused? And what action we have taken after the floods? isn't it?
Okay.
So you can just go through that, because then was the demolition of that apartments in Ernakulam, that Supreme Court order.
Yes. Okay, constructions and all.
So that is that CRZ 1, 2, 3 and all those things, what zone they were falling and all. So how we can prevent that? Something like that you can expect, isn't it?
Okay.
So yes. I think this is the main, and then of course you can ask about that Kerala diaspora outside, what are their contributions and all, isn't it? So those issues like Norca, and you can go to the Norca website and all, little bit information you keep, and you can smile. There's no ban on smiling, but it should be within that context also to be smile, no?
Yes, sir.
So context also, if serious, you talk serious and all, if you little bit this thing, but only you don't try to imitate something, you be natural, that's all.
Yes, I was being natural only, but I was trying to be more relaxed actually.
No artificial laughing, nothing, or smiling and all. Whatever is natural, natural, that's all. And trim your hair, beard and all, look very
smart. Sure,
and you're very young, sir. And you do very well. Hmm?
Sure,
all the best.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you.
Okay, all the best. Okay.
Thank
Welcome.
You,
Good day.
Good day. Yes.